have to go rescue my daughter. I have to go tell her who she is. She doesn't even know. And so she breaks out of the ice. She goes to the insane asylum. She picks her daughter up in this car, and they're driving away. This demonic werewolf creature comes, and he rips the top of the car off, and he reaches in so they can destroy this girl before she finds out who she really is. And as he goes in to reach in to grab her, she starts twitching, and her medicine's wearing off, and she starts to become her true self. And she reaches up, and she grabs the thing by the head with her bare hands and rips the thing in half. And I thought, this reminds me of Jesus. And so I realized, you know, when I was younger, my mom always talked to me about Jesus. She was a single mom. At one point, there were six of us kids. And it was really difficult financially, so she would always say, God's going to take care of us, you know, and he would. We wouldn't have nowhere to go. Somebody would open up their house. We would be able to stay there. We wouldn't have any food. Somebody would bring us food. And I watched God take care of us when I was younger. So I believed in God. And then when I was 10 years old, my cousin, who was three at the time, was beaten to death by his stepfather. And I thought, wait, wasn't God supposed to take care of us? What about him? How come God didn't take care of him? And then I became angry anytime anybody would talk about God, especially Jesus, because Christians were the loudest, and I just hated them more than everybody else. And I went around telling people how stupid they were to believe in God. And and I also had this commitment to being sad because of my cousin's death. Anytime I would catch myself laughing, I would say, no, I'm supposed to be sad because my cousin's death is just so sad. I should never be happy. And so I just began to only like people who hated people and only sad things. And I just taught myself how to be depressed. And by the time I was 16 years old, I was tired of waking up, and I decided to commit suicide. And on the day I planned to commit suicide, I had a miraculous encounter with this God I didn't believe in. And it's the reason why I'm still alive. I had an encounter with God himself. And it's the reason why I'm standing here. And one of the things I understood about God in that moment that I never understood from any Christians before that is that God created humanity to be these powerful, beautiful, amazing creatures of light and love and glory. And he said, but the only way that we can understand what love is if we have a choice to choose it out of our own free will. And so he said, I'm gonna give them the ability to choose. I'm gonna set before them life and death. And I'm gonna say, this is life, this is death. Choose life so you can live. And over, we choose death. We become less and less alive. As a people, as a human race, and individually, we choose death. We become more dead, and more, we become less alive. And over, he sends people. Tell them this is life, this is death. Choose life, and then over and over, they choose death. So finally, he says, you know what? I'm gonna take all those words I said about what life is, and I'm going to become a man. And so Jesus came to the earth to show us what it looks like to be a son of God, to be this powerful, beautiful, amazing creature that is full of love and light and glory. And he looked at all the people that everyone was spitting on and kicking down and saying was worthless. And he said, you are worth more than they have ever told you. Stand up and be who you were made to be. And he did it over and over and over. And then there's Satan. He came along and said, they chose death. They deserve death. They chose it. They deserve it. And they're going to die. And they deserve it. Chose death once, so I'm going to take care of that for everyone who wants to receive it. I'm going to take care of it on myself. And so he died. He allowed his creation, his people, to crucify him naked and bleeding and beaten and spit on and mocked on a cross. And the whole time, the devil's sitting right there. They're not going to choose you. They're not going to believe you. Look at them. They're spitting on you. They're mocking you. They'll never choose you. And there's a scripture that says God's gifts and his calling is without repentance. He won't ever repent of the gift he's given you. And so he's hanging there and he's saying, I don't care. They're going to have it if they want it. I'm going to die for them, and they're going to have total forgiveness and freedom. And so he can never accuse you again. He raises from the dead so that he can prove that death has no hold anymore on us, and we don't have to be slaves to death. And then he goes and he sits at the right hand of God and sends the earth his ghost, his Holy Ghost, so that anyone who asks for that and comes to him can be empowered by his ghost to overcome the slavery we've had to death all along. And we can be these powerful, beautiful, amazing creatures of light that we were made to be. And it reminded me of this vampire hybrid creature girl.